was just about to cut an apple for my lunch today, but welcome to my kitchen. My name's Amanda. For the past couple of weeks, I've also been serving lunch for others, but in a different kitchen and with a different apron. As part of a service learning project for my human development course, I have been volunteering for the Denver Rescue Mission, located in downtown Denver. While at the mission, my duties have included prepping meals by cutting up fruits, vegetables, and other foods, serving meals, and bussing tables. I chose to volunteer at the Denver Rescue Mission for a couple reasons. One, I have always been curious about what goes on in the building with the large Jesus Saves sign out front. And two, it was very easy to become a volunteer. All I had to do was go to www.denverrescuemission.org, click on Volunteer Denver Area, create a simple login account, sign up for a shift on their calendar, and show up. The Denver Rescue Mission primarily serves the homeless and lower socioeconomic status population. Their focus is providing emergency care, which corresponds with the mission's objective, to meet people at their physical point of need. This includes providing food, shelter, healthcare services, and other basic needs, such as clothing and transportation. As an aspiring mental health counselor, throughout my time spent volunteering, I kept thinking about Maslow's hierarchy of needs. American psychologist Abraham Maslow strived to understand what motivates people. He developed a 5-stage model shown visually as a pyramid. In order to reach the top of the pyramid, or self-actualization, which Maslow believed was the underlying drive for human nature, one must satisfy the needs of each level before moving up. The clients of the Denver Rescue Mission fall on the lowest level of the pyramid, which constitutes physiological needs: food, water, shelter, clothing, sleep. Therefore, the organization's purpose is to provide these resources to clients as a means to help boost them up to the next level, which would entail safety and security needs, such as security of employment, of resources, of family, of health, of property, and more. Through working with the mission staff members, volunteers, and mandated workers, as well as interacting with individuals being served, I believe the mission is finding success with this daunting task. In addition to providing emergency care and basic needs services, the mission also runs the New Life program. This program is for both men and women who are suffering from addiction, abuse, and other hardships, and aims to help transform lives through spiritual, emotional, and addictions counseling, education, and employment assistance. For the lunch service, not only was I working with other volunteers from the community, but I was also working with individuals in this program. I learned that the majority of these men had been recently released from prison and entered the program to get sober and change their lives. Still, in the mindset of a counselor, I couldn't help but relate many of these men's experiences with rehabilitation to Vygotsky's sociocultural theory of development. Lev Vygotsky was a Russian psychologist who emphasized the importance of studying the cultural, social, and historical influences that shape an individual's life. In regards to cognitive development, he proposed the zone of proximal development. For children to acquire new learning, they need to be in this zone, in which they can build upon previous learning while receiving guidance from others to strengthen their growth. This mentorship by others is also referred to as scaffolding. Whereas Vygotsky's theory is mainly discussed in terms of children, I believe his zone of proximal development can also be applied to adults. Of the men I talked to in the New Life program at the Denver Rescue Mission, I noticed two common themes among the stories I heard. First was reentry. One man explained how this was his second time entering the New Life program. He explained that he had participated in the program for 7 months previously, but left early, as he could not escape his drug addiction. He just did not feel ready. In terms of Vygotsky, he was not in the zone. This was a similar experience for many men who told me how their lives have been characterized by multiple stays in rehab, as well as prison for some, before they made the decision to get help and transform their lives. The second common theme I recognized was gratitude. Each man I spoke to couldn't say enough good things about the New Life program and how they are starting to feel more confident about their future. The Denver Rescue Mission is using scaffolding, or temporary support and guidance, through providing these men with basic physical needs and counseling to help rebuild their lives. Through my volunteer work, I have learned three major things. First, I learned about the importance of giving. Since moving to Colorado, I repeatedly talked about volunteering but never took action. Now that I know the process to volunteer can be made simple and easy, I am more motivated to continue searching for other opportunities and ways I can benefit my community.
Second, I learned that I am on the right career path. Upon completing my master's degree, I aim to become a professional counselor for the inmate population and help individuals as they transition from incarceration back to their communities. My interactions with the members of the New Life program has fueled my passion for the mental health field. I learned there is a great need for mental health professionals and services for those who are currently incarcerated and for those who are about to be released. Through my questions, I discovered that many men wished there had been more support and more services during their own transitions. Finally, this experience has reinforced my beliefs about the human condition. While it is necessary to recognize and acknowledge one's cultural background and history, I also think it's important to remember that people are people. We all experience birth. We all experience growth, changes, and development over the years and/or decades of our lifespan. And someday, we all will inevitably experience death. Regardless of past crimes committed, I, along with the Denver Rescue Mission, strongly believe in second chances.
Although I was prompted by a school assignment, I am extremely grateful I had the opportunity to volunteer with the Denver Rescue Mission. I found an organization that aligns with my values, as well as the personal mission for my career as a professional counselor. I also met some really great people, and I look forward to serving more shifts in the future. Additionally, I encourage you to explore the possible service learning projects in your own hometown. Whether it's volunteering to serve meals, donating food, or lending help in other ways, the contributions you make to support the healthy development and well-being of others will always be greatly appreciated. Thanks for listening.